For thousands of years, before the advent of instantaneous communication, global networks, satellites, and the internet, communication was much slower. Delivering handwritten letters was the most basic and long-standing means of communication, but some people wanted to remove the middleman entirely. Just as we now rely on wireless networks and microchips to do our heavy lifting, earlier generations used homing pigeons to deliver their messages across long distances. In movies and television, we have seen pigeons or ravens delivering messages, but can you really train a pigeon to deliver your mail? While delivering messages on horseback and on foot was satisfactory, it brought many unpredictable variables, including dishonest messengers, accidents, lost messages, unexpected delays, and a lack of guaranteed privacy. A faster and more reliable delivery system was needed. More than 3,000 years ago, homing pigeons were first introduced. Perceptive people noticed that birds had a wonderful sense of direction and could consistently find their way back to their nest from miles away. Pigeons are easy to capture, quick to breed, relatively docile, and highly in tune with their sense of direction. These pigeons would be trained very carefully, gradually being taken further and further from their nest before being released and flying home. In this way, pigeons could be programmed to fly home from a range of different locations. Unfortunately, this meant manually transporting large amounts of pigeons in one direction before having them released with a message attached to their leg, hoping they would return to the original location. These messages were typically small rolls of parchment or paper, stored in a small glass or metal tube. Rock pigeons were particularly gifted in this homing ability due to their strong magnetoreception skills. Magnetoreception is an innate ability in certain life forms to detect and orient themselves based on magnetic fields. Rock pigeons with the strongest ability were bred to create powerful and reliable homing pigeons. The biggest issue was the one-way trip for the birds, over land, before they could be released to fly home. Fortunately, this issue was solved. It was found that homing pigeons could be fed in one place and then deliver messages to the other. The birds could be coaxed to fly back and forth between two points, carrying messages to and fro. In the past, homing pigeons were essential aspects of politics, diplomacy, and even military action. Homing pigeons were used to share messages during wartime, as they were able to get through enemy lines much easier than a man on a horse. Historically, Genghis Khan used the pigeon post to stay in contact with distant points of his empire. In the 12th century, an extensive network of homing pigeons between Syria and Baghdad was established to link the two powers. While the training methods and means of communication differed in various parts of the world, the use of birds as reliable messengers occurred throughout history. If we didn't have the internet currently connecting every corner of the globe, we might still be using the pigeon post today.